Welcome back. To a brand new coffee tech break with Jan. Today, I want to take you through a brand new version of Studio USB version 1.5. Before I jump into my computer, let me take you through the basics. So the Studio USB has been through a tremendous period, as it is a great device to use in those small to mid-size rooms, especially during COVID, where people want to quickly dive into those meetings. There's a remote coming with this device, but most of the times you don't need it because you turn on speaker track or group track, which I will walk through in a bit. And then it's pretty easy. And you just dial into a meeting, you plug it into your laptop, and you're able to join those meetings, and the camera will find its way to the persons in the room. Really nice. Now, as I said, we got version 1.5. What I want to do today is walk you through those new features. I will do that as usual on my laptop. And also, I will show you how easy it is to upgrade to that new release, to that 1.5. Additionally, we will have Lens. So in 1.5, on the first time, you can integrate it now fully into Lens. You have like device information now in Lens. You can restart it in Lens. So you got all those features now. But don't worry, I will walk it through as usual on my laptop. And so you should be fine if you just run it through. As usual, let me jump in my laptop now and walk you through all those great features of the Studio USB. Now, as usual, what I would say is grab a cup of coffee, sit back, relax, and enjoy the presentation. As I said, the Studio USB really stands out at the moment, the speaker bar. It seems to work out really well for a lot of meetings. The device performs really well. You can manage it centrally. So you got all those functionalities, which fulfills the need for a lot of customers. So today, I would jump into a brand new version, 1.5. So what do we have in 1.5? And also, as I said, I will run through the upgrade process, which is pretty easy, but I will just run it all through so you're fully up to date with all those brand new functionalities. As I said, Studio USB, a really powerful speaker bar, easy, just put into a meeting room. As I show me here, just put it on top of the screen against the wall, or using the Visa bracket, which is also there. You come in with your laptop as the use case, you put in that USB cable in the laptop, and automatically your camera, speaker, and mic will be transferred here to the Studio USB. So you can really quickly collaborate with each other. You don't need any codec there, which at the end is a possibility, as the device is Teams certified, Zoom certified, etc. So you could use it also natively with a codec. You can even hook it up to the G7500 if you want as a USB peripheral. But always check which applications are supported with that device. Now, very easy, as I said. So this use case is really easy. And this is also, I think, what made the device very, very successful in the market. Also, if you look at the video providers supported, it's massively. So as you see here, you got a really big list of video providers available. And I would say just check the release notes. So look always in the comments where we'll put that additional information. So probably you'll find already a lot of information there, but this is really a reference for me. If there is some information which I'm showing here, always check the release notes, where you can find this easily, and the reference, I will capture them there. As I said, it is really the star of the show at the moment, Studio USB, working with all those video providers out there in the market. Tracking options. There's nothing in the market which does so many tracking options and can fulfill so many use cases. As you see here, working with presenter tracking, so able to follow that presenter in the room, even with a mask. So due to COVID, it could be that people wear a mask it's able to track you. And I will put a video here, a link where you're able to see that and how easy it follows me during some demonstrations. Group framing also, just by default, it's just a matter of turning into group track or speaker track or whatever functionality you need. So the group tracking means that people will sit in the room and it tries to create that most optimal picture of that participants. So as you see here, is there sitting four participants there, it will zoom out. And also you can set the framing size. So depending how you set the framing size, tight, medium, or wide, and depending on how much you want to zoom in, this is also which you can configure. And I will show you that a bit later where you can do those settings. Speaker tracking, really nicely. So just able to zoom into a specific speaker in that room. Now, one other thing is conversation mode. I think really powerful. Conversation mode made it possible that when two participants in the room are talking to each other, it will automatically split the screen. So you will see both them in a discussion and it will show both participants. Really, really powerful. These are just some built-in functionality. There's no additional license or there's not a special application needed on your PC. This is all just built into the Studio USB. Now, a feature which is also built into the Studio USB is acoustic fans. It's really nice. So I will put a link also up there where you're able to find a demo video of that. Really nice. So you can configure this fans and customize it to the table. So it will only hear the participants here at the table. And anything outside will be filtered out as much as possible. So I think really, really nice feature. Similar to noise block, as we have those open offices, it could be a coffee machine, it could be somebody sitting with lunch, anything. So noise block will specifically filter out any other noise than your voice. We almost forget those features, but these are all built into the Studio USB. I think really powerful. And as you see here, most of the users stay unmuted during meetings. So if you sit inside those meeting rooms, it would always be a possibility that there is some additional noise and that people don't mute that room. So these are just built in. Now let's look at a brand new feature in Studio USB 1.5. Now one that's really exciting, especially in today's world, is a meeting room capacity notification. So what happens is the Studio USB is connected here to the MTR for Windows and it's able to send out a message to the Teams admin that the room is overutilized. So in other words, there's too much people in that room. It was something that Microsoft placed on their public roadmap and now you see that this feature is being generally available. Now, what will happen if a participant sitting in that room, the Studio USB will count the participants there all the time and also will feed that back into Teams Admin Center. Now, if it sees that there's too much participants there, you're able to get probably a message on the screen or in Teams Admin Center. And then, yeah, sorry, as a friendly, you're gonna ask that other colleagues need to move out of the room to make sure that you are with the right number of people in that room. A really nice feature, which is available now in Studio USB. You need to upgrade to 1.5 first and enable it, which I will show you a bit later, as it is a tick in the box in the Lens app, and then you're able to use this. What is good to know is this feature also works, for example, with the Studio P15 and also with the Studio E70. So all of our cameras for the meeting rooms are ready for this new room capacity notification. But as I said, in combination with MTR for Windows. Now, another brand new feature is now the support for FTPS and HTTPS provisioning with Studio USB. So if your Studio USB is hooked up to the network and using the Wi-Fi module, you're able to connect it up to an FTP S-server or HTTP S-server. This is if you don't want to use, for example, Resource Manager from Poly, which we recommend, or you use a Poly Lens in the cloud, which will give you that most optimal management process. But if you don't want to use that or is no possibility, you can always fall back to these manual sort of provisioning ways, because you're going to work with XML files, but you can at least do some sort of centralized provisioning if you want to. Now, another brand new feature in the Studio USB is the migration to Poly Lens. So we will be slowly moving away from PDMS-E. So what we support now in the 1.5 is that you can add all the lens information and redirect your Studio USB, redirect that to the Poly Lens Cloud platform. Really easy. So you just add this configuration information into your configuration file. You push that out to your Studio USBs, which you have hooked up through the Wi-Fi, and then it will automatically be redirected, and you should be able to see them showing up in the Lens Cloud platform. Now, I got a great colleague, Uwe. He created a blog about this configuration, so I won't discuss that in detail here, but I will put in the comments, I will put a link to Uwe, his blog, where you can find all the information, how you can redirect from PDMS-E to Lens, and he created some great screenshots and description with it, which I think is really helpful to guide you step by step with this process. Let me walk you now through how you can get to 1.5. So probably you're now on 1.4. So what are the possibilities? So first off, you can hook this up to your laptop and just use the Companion app, as you probably use today, but you can also use the new Lens app if you have that. So that will be a possibility when you just hook it up to your laptop and you can do a local upgrade. And this is also which I will show you a bit later. Now, if you have to have the Studio USB hooked up to the Wi-Fi, to your PDMS-E, or to your local resource manager, that is of course also a possibility. Just download the package and upload it in PDMS-E onto your local resource manager, and it will be an upgrade as soon as the system is available. Now, why this whole transition to the Poly Lens app? I think this is really important. So this is our vision. All the devices, all the Poly devices, P5, P15, E70, Sync family, all those devices are coming together in the Poly Lens app. All the headsets that we have. And so you see more and more devices getting available. So if you want to do that locally, that's also a possibility, of course. So if you just have one or two units, you can always just hook up that Poly Lens, install it on your laptop, and you're able to upgrade, set specific settings, etc. Similar, if you have a Teams Room system, you just install the Poly Lens application and you're able to manage the Studio USB, just like as you do today with the Companion app. Now, this is the application that you can use, where you got all your devices. Now, what comes along is as soon as you have the Studio USB also hooked up to the Wi-Fi network, there's a Lens agent now in 1.5, and that Lens agent works perfectly with Lens in the cloud. So you were able to do a little bit of configuration in the past, but now it will go much further than that. So what you will see with the Lens agent inside, you got much more information. So all the information from Studio USB is available, but also the configuration information. So you can set now from Poly Lens in the cloud, you can set now your speaker tracking, group tracking, everything centrally from that environment. I think this is really nice. You can see if the device is online, device is offline. You got a restart button. So in case you got some unexpected behavior, you can always initiate and now that restart from the Poly Lens in the cloud. Now, as usual, we're gonna do the practical thing. This is what a lot of people always like, so let me walk it all through. Pretty straightforward. The first step, I will upgrade to the Companion app. That is what most people use, so I will show that through a companion app. The other thing is I will move then over to the lens application and show you all the different features there. Then we're gonna enable it for PolyLens in the cloud. And so you will see that popping up in the cloud. We walk you through that functionality. And by the way, if you have option 160 enabled in your Wi-Fi network, you can also put it automatically in the lens cloud. So that is also a possibility. If you have that DHCP option there and you have the information of the lens cloud there, it will pop up automatically in the lens cloud to manage the device. So really, really flexible, but I will walk it all through. Now, let's go to the practical piece, which is for me always the nice part of those sessions. So let me walk you through and also a little bit to the basics. So maybe not everybody played around with the application, with Studio USB, or know where the documentation is. So let me just quickly give some references here. So first off, where you need to go for the software. So you go for Studio USB software to support.polycon.com, and there you're gonna find, under peripherals, you're gonna find Studio USB, as you see here. And as you can see, the software is now published here, the 1.5 release, which is available. So you got one which is for the provisioning, and you got here one available which can be used by the companion app. So this file is what I already downloaded to make sure that I have it on my laptop and you can use that. And also you can find the release notes here. Very nice. So the release notes, I would always recommend to just run it through for any specifics. As you can see here, you got all that information in here about the notification on Teams, release history, specific features, etc. So always run that through to see if there's any details which I overlooked here in my video. Now, so what I've done is I've downloaded this, the companion app for local update, to make sure that I have that available. Now, where can you find the companion app? Right here. So you just click here on Polycom companion app, and this application will be able to detect Studio USB, and then you can upgrade it. You can do the same thing with PolyLens. So if you already have the PolyLens app on your laptop, great. And you can use that also and do a standalone upgrade, which I can show you a bit later when we are walking through the local lens application. Now, the other thing which I wanted to mention is documents.polycom.com. Also a very nice URL for any device information you're looking for. So here you got everything in HTML available. So you got here video conferencing, speaker phones, cloud services. Really nice. It's a great reference. So if I click here on video conferencing, what you will see is you can find those personal solution and webcams right here. So you got all this information together. I can click on Studio USB. And what you can see here is you find that parameter reference guide where you can find those provisioning parameters. But also you see here the 1.5, the user guide, is also available here. So any additional information can really quickly be found. And I will put those URLs, I will put them in the comments, as I said. So anything I'm using here, I will make sure that you got reference in the comments where you're able to quickly find that information. Now, the next step is upgrade your Studio USB to the 1.5 release. So I will be using the companion app, but if you got the lens app, you can also do it right there. And I will show you that later on where I also transfer over to the lens app. Now, if you got resource manager or any other provisioning, you can download it right here. And also the local companion app upgrade file is also right here, which I already downloaded here on my machine. Now, here you go. Let me show you the upgrade process through the companion app. So you just click here on the device and now we'll jump right in. If you haven't used the companion app, what I will ask you is to walk through a wizard. So be aware there is a default password. Let me show you that. Now, in the documentation, in the user guide, you will find the initialize the Studio USB and walking through that first time setup wizard. So you will find the default password right there. And so that will give you the ability to log in into the Companion app. As soon as you've done that, you will end up right here in this screen. This is where you can find all the information about the Poly Studio, and there's no provisioning server configured yet, which I will do through the Lens app. There's no IP address because it's not hooked up to the network. As you can see right here, the Wi-Fi is not available, but I will run that through using the Lens application. Now, then we go here to the tab where you can find firmware update. And here you can see that My Studio USB is running that 1.4. And here you will find the option update from local file to use that configuration, that upgrade file, which I showed you earlier on the download side, where you need to upload that. Click on update from local file. And here you see I already downloaded that file to make sure that we can run through the video quickly. You click on it and here you go. Now the upgrade process will start. This will take approximately 5 to 10 minutes. I would say get a cup of coffee and I'll see you back in a bit. And here you go. After 5 to 10 minutes, I am now have the Studio USB at version 1.5. So it's running now that Lens agent inside the Studio USB. So now we have the ability to integrate it fully into the Lens cloud environment. So what we will do now is we're going to transfer to the Poly Lens app. And so we're going to move away from the Companion app. Now, first off, where can you download the Lens application? Let me show you that. So here you can find Lens application on the Poly website. What I will do, I will put this link also in the comments so you have that available. So with the Lens app, it's available for Mac and available for Windows. And as you can see, you will be able to find all your devices that are hooked up. You're able to tweak the camera. You can find also some health information and wellness information in there. So it's not only managing your device, but it's also managing your health and wellness. And this will probably extend more and more with new features and benefits. But this is the new application forward, which you're able to use in your environment. So you need to download it. You go here, I go to Windows, you download the software client, and then you start it. So after you've installed the Poly Lens app, what you will see, and I would say just exit and quit the Companion app so they're not both running at the same time, because that could give some conflicts. But you could keep it on the PC, but just don't start them and run them at the same time. So we use the Lens app that should detect the Studio USB, as you see here. And you will find a nice overview of all the device information. And so as we haven't configured yet, the network, it will say disconnected. Status is the device is connected. The provisioning is something we haven't configured yet here, as there's no connection here to the outside. It's called by default Studio, but of course you can change that name by going here, for example, to the right lower side, and here you have the ability to change it to Studio Coffee Jack USB, for example. Then let me save it. So here you can just change the name. And you, so you probably use those devices in different rooms, but you can also do this through the Poly Lens in the cloud, of course. But if you locally want to change that to get an overview of just have a couple of rooms, you are able to use this also on your own Poly Lens app. Now, let me walk you through the different configuration settings and the controls of the camera. First off, the controls. So how do you control the camera itself? So here you can have a preview of the camera, which is now turned off as the slider is now, the privacy shutter is enabled there, so you don't have the view now. But here you can see what the camera sees and adjust it to your needs. As you can see here, you got all kinds of settings which you can customize. Also, you can create favorites. You can create several favorites for this device. Really nice. Just depending on the room, the lighting, etc. You can turn on backlight compensation, exposure. You can tweak the tracking maximum zoom, which I usually recommend a maximum of 3 times, which should be sufficient. Here you can auto pan or you can cut. Auto pan means that the camera really transitions nicely from one person to another. But also if you put that to cut, that means it will jump from one person to another. Well, that auto pan, I think, is really nice for the remote participants where they see that nice transition from the different persons in the room, or moves out from group track and shows all the participants. I think that's very nice, but depends. And this is very personal and could depend on different rooms and environments. Here you can set tracking speed, slow, normal, or fast, just like we have with the companion app. So if you want to do those fast movements or you really want to do that more slowly, you can really customize that. Same for the frame size. So how much do you want to zoom in, for example, to a speaker? Do you want to have that medium or do you want to have that tight? And tight means that it's trying to zoom as much as possible to the speaker in that room. So this is where you really can customize and you can create your favorites. Now, the next step, which I wanted to show you, are the settings. So we got admin settings, we got general settings and audio setting. First off, the admin settings. Now, what we have here is we got the NTP. So NTP is important because if you want to load certificates to make secure connections with the device, timing is super important. So you could do that auto, where it will retrieve it using DHCP, or you can set it to manually, where you can add an NTP server on the network. Now, here you got some vivid mode setting. Here you can create the blue, the red, the orange. You can just boost those colors a little bit, which by default is on, but you can turn it off if you want. Now, here we'll find also the Wi-Fi setting, which is by default disabled. So you need to enable this to make a connection to the PolyLens cloud, if you want that, or make a connection to any provisioning server externally. So let me do that right now. What it will do is we'll scan the environment. So the Wi-Fi client that is built into the Studio USB will scan the environment. And here you're able to select your Wi-Fi SSID where you want to hook this one up. To connect to that network, you put in the password and you say join. Now we'll be joining now my lab network, which is called Michael Jackson. And so auto connecting to that also. Now, what you will see is as soon as it is connected, it should be able to prompt you with this information, which gives you an indication of the connection to the outside. Now, also, if you go a little bit down to the next setting, is Bluetooth. So Bluetooth is specifically for your remote control or Bluetooth to hook it up to your phone. If you want to play some music on Friday afternoon or you want to take the Studio USB at home to use it for a party, anything is possible. As what here, you can turn on and off the auto connect with the Bluetooth. You can use a remote control set, a remote control that comes with Studio USB usually, and you don't need a remote control as it will mostly be done by the auto tracking, etc. But of course, the possibility is there. Now, then we got the password. So here you can change the password that is where you can change the password of going into those admin settings. And now we're coming at the provisioning server information. Provisioning server, provisioning mode, auto. So it will go onto the network and find the Lens server in the cloud information. In this case, I've added that information into my DHCP server in my home lab. So if I go into manual, it should be able to pop in all that information. As you can see, it's already found that information. Really nice. So it automatically puts the information here into my client. So I have it available. So I will leave it to auto. So it should automatically connect to that environment and you save it. Really nice, this feature. So don't know if you have the possibility in your home lab or in the office and your Wi-Fi network to add the Lens cloud environment, but then you're able to add it. So I will put in the comments, I will put a link to find this provisioning information, which option to use, how you can configure that, etc. Now, here you can import and export your configuration. Really nice. So if you got this specific configuration, specific settings, you can export it. You could import them in another Studio USB you have. And here you can go for the certificates. So if you got any certificates you need to install to make those secure connections, that's also a possibility. Restart the device here locally. Restore defaults. So if you got some sort of issue, you don't know what it is, unexpected behavior, you could also restore. Then it will come into the default password. So that is good to know. You're falling back into the default password of Studio USB, which I showed you a bit earlier. And these are all the admin settings. Now, the next settings we want to run through are the general settings in Studio USB. For example, the participants count. This is something which we talked through earlier. So here you can count the participants in the room and report that back into your Teams Admin Center environment. Really nice. So you should enable this if you want to use that functionality. Here you can enable stereo audio. So in case you want to use it as a Bluetooth stereo speaker, then you can enable that. If you want to show some information on the video output, that's also a possibility. So it will push this out through your USB connected, through your camera settings. So this is for troubleshooting. Of course, we got the anti-flicker information. So this is to match the lightning information in your environment. Now we can go to audio. Really nice. Here we find the acoustic fans, which I also talked through earlier. Really recommend to play around with that. You can put it in narrow. That means that the microphones are really in a narrow situation, picking up the audio. Medium, that will be a bit wider, picking up the audio. And wide means it will generally pick up most of the audio. Outside that, it will block it. So really, really nice. Acoustic fans. Similar to noise block, which I also discussed earlier, it's able to block out any other noise besides voice. As you see here, you can do this for outgoing audio, but also you can filter some audio coming in. That's also a possibility. And further, you can tweak the bass and the treble. These are the settings. Now, lastly, under the support. So here you will find quick start guide, user guide reference, the device info. So here you find the serial number, the software version. Also, you can upload that customized software. So that 1.5, which I use through the companion app, you could do the same here. If you want to upload that to the new and upgrade it to the newer software. And also you can download logs. So in case you are open a troubleshoot ticket, you're trying to find some specific issue, you can always download the logs right here. That is for the support. Then we got here the information to contact support. So if you need to find some more information based on your serial number, etc., this is all the information which you need. Now the last thing you need to do is make sure you reboot. Don't forget it. You need to reboot to make sure that it will refresh and hook up to the lens in the cloud. As to do that, you go to settings and you could also just unplug the power, of course. And then you go here to restart. Yes, and you restart the device. After the system has been rebooted or unplugged the power, there's also a possibility. You should be able to see under overview that we got all green lights now. So it's hooked up to my lab network. It's all connected. We can see the provisioning server information is now in the device. So it should be showing up in Lens. And so let's go to the Lens environment now and show you how that looks like. Now, welcome into the Poly Lens environment. So you can go to lens.poly.com. Don't have an account, you can easily sign up here with an account. You got a Microsoft account, you got a Google account, you can set that up free of charge. There are some additional licenses available, which is called Poly Plus. So if you, for example, want to have notification, devices go down, etc., there are some licenses available, but I would always recommend to check with your poly partner or your poly representative in your local region to check it out. Now, what I'm going to do is let me log in now to my tenant. Now, after you log in, you come into the home screen. And so here you will find the inventory, you will find the actions, that means devices which are online, and you got insights, room insights. And so here's a lot of development going on where you can find more information about the room, the usage, etc. So I always recommend to play around with those settings to review that. Now, let me go to the inventory. Now, I should be able to go here now to Studio USB. So let me search for Studio USB. And as you can see, the device has been come online now. You can find it here on my network. It is provisioned, as you see, so it is active and the device is online. Now, as I said, if you have a Poly Plus agreement on your device, you could even set up notifications if the device goes offline or something. So there's a lot of things going on in the Poly Lens environment, which is by the basis free. So you can set up configurations, you can push out software, etc. But there's more additional information coming, which could ask for a license. So as I said, always check with your Poly representative. Now, here you'll find all that information, the serial number, IP addresses, etc. You can assign it to a room. So what I will do is let me click now on that Studio USB. And here you go. Really nice. So you got now edit the device information. And now you have that new option, restart the device. And also you can delete the device if you want to remove it from your tenant. Now, here you can find the IP addresses, private IP addresses, room information. Now, to edit the information, then you go to edit, and here you can assign it now, for example, to a site, so to my home lab. I can give the room a name, which is Studio Rooms. You can just configure anything here and save settings. Now, there's a lot of new functionality available in Poly Lens, so you could configure now specific groups. So if you want to first upgrade a couple of devices with newer versions, you could create groups, test groups. There's also policies, so you can create policies based on a model, a device group, on a site, which is usually based on an IP address, and based on an individual device. And this is also the priority. So the highest priority is a setting specifically on a device. Really nice. So there's a lot of things which you can do, and I just recommend to just get an account in Poly Lens and just play around with it. As you can see here, you can easily add a device to a specific group, and then you can also configure specific settings for that group, which could be a location or a specific group devices for a specific environment. Really nice. Now, further, what do we have here is under settings, we have the same settings that we had locally with the Lens app. You can find them also here centrally in the Lens in the cloud. So here you can change the image enhancements, you can change camera settings. So if for a day, instead of frame speaker, you need to have frame group, you can push this out right here to your Studio USB. Tracking speed, you can change that. The zoom factor, also you got here the presenter mode. So if you need the presenter mode that follow the speaker mode live, that's also an option. And you can enable your conversation view. Conversation view is that you got, if you got two participants having a discussion, it will show them both into the video. Really nice. So you can all do this centrally, as I said, locally on the device or through a specific group. I think it's really flexible with Lens. Now, if you look under audio settings, there's also an interesting option, and that is here, the preferred mic is the mic pod. So if you have that additional mic pod, which is an accessoire, it comes by default with a cable, so it's a wired extension mic. It's around 7.6 meters long, that cable that comes with it, but you can put that further out into the room. Now, by default, if you hook this one up, it will use this as the default mic in the room. Now, what you will see is here in Lens in the Cloud, you have an option to put it to auto. And that means it will mix the mic pod with the audio mics in the Studio USB. So you got really that great coverage. Usually this is used in the educational market, where you got Studio USB at the beginning. You put this into the class, and that will pick up the students, but also the teacher who will be talking through the classroom. So you really got this additional mic there. There's also a mute button, which you just hover over it, and then you can mute it. So really flexible. That is that mic pod setting. So you can find that also here. Noise block, acoustic fan settings. Then under general settings, you can turn the Bluetooth here on and off. So you can find all those settings here. Also, software updates. So in case you need to push out new software, you can do this automatically. Or what I usually recommend is to create specific groups and first test it out. Make sure that the 1.5, for example, works correctly in your environment. And then you can upgrade the rest of your devices. Really nice. So this is Poly Lens in the Cloud doing centralized configuration. Lastly, what I wanted to mention, as usually, just check those release notes. I cannot mention that more. This is where you can find all the details. What is also in the release notes are, for example, the USB extenders. So these are extenders which are tested and supported also by Poly. So make sure you always check out that information. Now, here ends my coffee tech break session for today on the Studio USB 1.5. Hopefully you enjoyed it. If you got any questions, I would say just leave them in the comments and I will try to give you an answer. Also, if you like this type of video, I would say just subscribe to my channel. But also in 2022, I'll keep you updated on the latest and greatest. Thank you for watching, and hope to see you back in the next video.